All right, so place accumulators underway out at the big tee, and good to see the crowds have come through, and lovely win over here by Lady of Steel, number four in the program, the daughter of Gimme the Green Lights. Well done to the Breitenbach family. Good to have Johan Janssen van Vieren on course, of course, Justin for Mark, and Gavin Larina does duty for the punters once more. Well done, Gav. Certainly a filly that I know you think highly of, and she got the trip nicely this afternoon.
Yeah, she did. She did it so well for me. Obviously, there were a lot of question marks going the distance. The ground is testing with the headwind, and she had quite a lot of weight to shoulder. So, you know, nothing was all, you know, none of the boxes were ticked, but she's come out here today, and she's just wonderful. She's so easy to work with, and she quickened up beautifully for me.
I think you've said it all. Of course, I know hopefully you'll keep the relationship with her, because I think she's got bigger and better things to come, and obviously, well done up until now, Gav.
Thank you very much, Ben. Yeah, she's a wonderful filly. I'm hoping I can stick with her. Big thank you to Johan and his team. They've done a phenomenal job with her, and you know, every time you sit on her, you can just feel the improvement. So it's well done to Jan and his team. To Justin, thank you very much. And to Mr. and Mrs. Breitenbach, great to get the hat-trick for you guys.
Lovely stuff. Well done, Gav.
Thank you.
Super. Well done to Gavin Larina. Well done, Johan. Good to have you on course this afternoon. And I know she's a filly that you've always thought quite a bit of.
Yeah, listen, from her last run onwards, you know, after first win, she improved quite a bit. And from her last one, she improved some more. She wasn't a filly that showed fireworks from day one, but she's just so mentally intelligent that she does everything the right way. You know, she just runs when she has to run, and she almost trains herself, this filly. You know, I mean, she was one of those fillies just got left in the other ring, and she did her work every day. She never... you never like got excited, you know. She just from day one knows what she had to do, and yeah, I didn't have a very long time Justin organizer for me, so thank you very much to Justin, and a huge thank you to Renier and Gemma for actually giving Justin the rein and letting him send the filly to me.
Now, Johan, obviously early days, we don't want to jump the gun. She's stepped up to every task that you put in front of her. You got any immediate plans, or are you just going to go home and take it day by day?
You know, obviously we started with the filly a bit later, you know, she only came to me, I think, in October, so we couldn't obviously rush her, and I would have loved to get a filly in the Guineas, but it's going to be too soon, so we're going to skip that. I might nominate for the Acacia, depending on what penalty she gets today, and then we'll probably get a nice lightweight there, and draw depending, so we'll probably have a go there if she pulls up well, and she looks like the right field for her.
And now you've got two more left. Veritas, I think her last two runs, we can put a line through that. I think she's a lot better.
Yeah, listen, Veritas in Durban, she bled. She never showed any signs of bleeding ever at home, so I was quite surprised that day. Yeah, she's quite a difficult filly. She's given it a hard time over her career, temperament-wise, and that's why she hasn't had a lot of runs. And when we eventually got her right in Durban, she bled, so it was back another 3 or 4 months. So we had to start from scratch again, and she has 1,000. Obviously, was way out at the weights and needed a gallop. So, yeah, I said to the guys this morning, we're going to do it old school, and not that they're laughing at me because they say I'm not old school, but I feel like I'm old school in this game. But anyway, yeah, we're going to run a fit and do a little bit less. She's a bleeder, and you know, I think she'll be a lot fitter next time around.
And then Mohican, I know also you've always thought quite a bit of. Last time out, things didn't go according to plan.
Yeah, I said to the guys in my group this morning, I said, what you guys see in form is not what I've seen at home yet. He does show tremendous work at home. He always has. I feel he's still an immature horse. I feel he's very leggy. I feel he's very weak. A lot of our Argentinian horses over the years at my old stable used to like only come to the very best at late 3-year-olds and 4-year-olds, you know. So I do think he's a really smart horse. This might be, I wouldn't say too soon for him, but I just think you're going to see a better horse in 3 or 4 runs from now.
Jan, as always, Justin for Mark, lovely to have you. It's a busy man doing wonders for racing, as always, and good to be representing the Breitenbach family, who I know you're very close with.
Yeah, I just wanted to say a few words on behalf of Renier and Gemma, obviously, and most importantly, I think, well done to Joey Ramsden, because he bought this filly at the 2-year-old sale. She was quite an expensive horse, but she's out of Group 1 winning mare, and she's just loaded with ability, and Joey always felt top early on, and then obviously just prior to that, Renier and Gemma asked if we could just help with relocating some of the horses around, and I thought this filly would suit the 3-year-old filly program in TURFFONTEIN. And she's 3 from 3 now, and hopefully she can bag a nice stakes race at some stage, and she'll be worth in the brief. So well done to Gemma and Renier. They're in Qatar at the moment. Sent me a picture of his long, tall, quadruple Clip Drift Premium, and well done for the support and letting us make the right decisions for the horses between Johan and myself, and it's reaping the rewards.
Now, Justin, obviously, whilst we got you here, we've spoken a bit about Green Street. They're doing really well at the moment. I saw your post the other day. You're well into the 80s in terms of winners now?
Yeah, 83 or 84, somewhere around there. But it's, it's a tough slog, but we're going on okay. And I think this year, the New Year's resolution, if you would have, was to try and get more horses in feature races. And we closed off the year with Leopold, obviously, winning the Secretariat. And Herodotus is second, the Peninsula Handicap. So we're getting some horses at the higher end, which is obviously a result of buying more expensive horses over the years have gone on. And hopefully Mohican, he is the first horse I bought in Argentina. He was quite a cheap horse. He landed, yeah, just over 400,000 rand. So relatively cheap for an import, you know. And he's running in a group race. So whether he win, lose or draw, he's in the shake-up there. And hopefully in the next couple of months, he becomes a decent horse.
I know you're a man of form. Give us an early winner of the Sun Met.
That's a tricky one. I think I liked Vardy for the Lormont's Queen's Plate. I couldn't understand how he's such a big price after demolishing the field before. But I'm not one of these people who thought that Hawam ran his race there, because all the experts afterwards saying he's beaten nothing. But he demolished Twist of Fate twice before, and Twist of Fate beat him there. So clearly he didn't run his race. So I think he'll be back on Met Day, and it'll be a Vardy-Hawam fight out.
Lovely stuff. Good to have him, of course, cool, as always.
Thank you very much.
Lovely. Cheers. Well done to Justin for Mark. Good to have him out, Chair. Certainly doing wonders for racing. And do yourself a favour. Go and check out the Green Street Bloodstock page. You'll have a lot of fun. Buy yourself a horse. Cheap. Not going to cost you too much. Come out to the course, and hopefully you'll be leading in a winner. Good one, yeah. Lady of Steel, number 4 on the programme. I know many punters play today was Lady of Steel. Well supported in the markets, and she's come home as easy as she likes.